In this part, we'll develop a shelf script to help us control the position of several transform nodes relative to a central object. To visualize our approach, we'll first create locators at the original position of each hexagon. For each hexagon, we'll create a point constraint to position it between its locator and the central sphere. Then, we'll create a custom attribute on the sphere and use an expression to drive the weight of each point constraint. This way, when the custom attribute is set to 100, the hexagons will be repelled away from the sphere. When the custom attribute's value approaches 0, the hexagons will be drawn towards the sphere. Let's identify our new script as expandFromFirst.py. For our script to work, we'll need at least two transform objects in an ordered selection list. We'll refer to the first object in this ordered selection as the central object. The remaining objects will be attracted or repelled relative to this central object. Create an empty group into which we'll be storing all our locators. Recall that Maya replaces the pound symbol with an incrementing number to ensure that the group's name is unique. Iterate over each object in the selection list. To obtain the position of the object, use the getAttr command. The argument for this command is the object's translation attribute name. This command returns a list, but we're only interested in the first element, which contains the object's coordinates. We can condense these two lines by removing the temp result variable and accessing the first element directly after the call to getAttr. Create a locator with the space locator command. Set the position flag to the object's coordinates. Set the locator's name to contain the name of the current object, followed by a number to uniquely identify it. The resulting locator's name is returned in the element indexed at 0. To center the locator's pivot at its current position once it's been created, call the xform command and set the center pivots flag to true. Use the parent command to group the newly created locator under its designated group. Outside the for loop, center the locator group's pivot with another call to xform. Select the sphere, and then the hexagons, and run the script. The result is a new group of locators positioned in the same location as the hexagons. Let's delete this group for now to continue working on our script. Call the point constraint command to constrain the object between the target and its locator. The first argument is a list of two points between which the object will be constrained. The second argument is the constrained object itself. We'll base the new constraint's name on the object being constrained. To drive the weights of this constraint, we'll create a custom attribute on the target called expansion. Above the for loop, set the max expansion variable to 100. We'll need to use this variable several times throughout the script. Set the new attribute name variable to expansion. Check whether or not this attribute exists by calling the objExists command. If this attribute doesn't exist, we'll add it to the target. Call the select command on the target and call addAttr to add a new attribute to the currently selected object. Set the attribute type to double to ensure the attribute can be set to decimal values. Set the minimum value to 0, the maximum value to max expansion, and do the same for the default value flag. To make the new attribute appear in the channel box, set its keyable flag to true. Run the script on the current selection. When you select the sphere again, notice that it now has a new expansion attribute, which is set to 100 by default. To manually create an expression to drive the weights of a point constraint, select one of the hexagon's point constraints. In the channel box, click on the first weight and select Edit Expressions. Use the following expression to determine the hexagon's attraction towards the sphere. As the expansion approaches a value of 100, the resulting expression will approach a value of 0, therefore reducing the weight of the sphere on the hexagon. Contrary to the sphere, the weight of the hexagon's locator is directly proportional to the expansion value, so we can connect these attributes directly. Select Window, General Editors, Connection Editor. Click on the sphere and reload the left tab. Click on the point constraint and reload the right tab. Select the sphere's expansion attribute and connect it to the point constraint's locator weight. Now, when we select the sphere and modify the expansion attribute, the weight of the point constraint will be correctly modified for that hexagon. Let's undo this work for now and see how we can repeat these steps in our script. Call cmds.expression to create an expression. Set the always evaluate flag to true to ensure this expression is constantly evaluated by Maya. Set the expression's name to contain the current object's name. Set the object flag to the point constraint's name. This is the expression's default object. Setting this flag makes the expression slightly less verbose, as any floating attributes will be associated to this default object. The string flag contains the expression itself. We want to assign the weight of the sphere to the following expression. Using the following string substitutions, the expression we had written earlier is now applied to all the point constraints. Use the connectAttr command to connect the value of the expansion attribute to the point constraint's locator weight. The first argument is the source attribute, and the second argument is the destination. When we run this script on our selection, the sphere's expansion attribute now drives the weights of all the constraints. Save this script to your shelf and name it expand. You can also save it to your file system as expandfromfirst.py. To review our progress throughout this series, let's rebuild our scene using the shelf scripts we've developed. Start with the cylinder and modify it to turn it into a beveled hexagon. With the hexagon selected, click on the Random Instances shelf script. We'll give these hexagons a metallic red material. Add a sphere into the scene. Select it, and then the hexagons, and run the Aim at First shelf script. With the hexagons now aiming towards the sphere, run the Expand from First shelf script on the current selection. A set of locators is created on each hexagon, and the expansion attribute is added to the sphere. Combine the instance group and the locator group, and name the new group Hex Shield. Select the Hex Shield group, and run the UI Rote shelf script. Set the time range from 1 to 132, and press Apply. To see the resulting animation, expand the time slider's range to frame 132 and press play. Manually key the sphere's expansion value to 100 on frames 1 and 132. Go to frame 66 and key an expansion value of 50. To see the resulting animation, press play. Assign a surface shader to the sphere to give it the appearance of a central glowing core at render time. Add a directional light in the scene and enable lights and shadows in the viewport. Add a point light at the center of the core. To make sure this light reflects off the inner surface of the hexagons, we'll have to unlink it from the central sphere. The scene is now ready to be rendered. We've touched on a variety of topics in this series, including basic object manipulation, working with the user's selection, scripted animations, UI creation, and expression generation. With these fundamentals in hand, you can experiment with your own creative scripting workflows.